Good morning. New advanced technologies can give us, human beings, superpowers. Think of the GPS, the navigation systems that you're so accustomed to in your car. They actually help you find your way without knowing your way. Think of 3D printers, which enable consumers to actually print products in the comfort of their own house. Or think of new speech-to-speech technologies. Technologies which actually make it easier for you to travel while having to learn, no, not even one new language. And as you can see, new technology even makes it possible to win against Bayern Munich. As an Ajax fan, that's of course still a dream, but in technology it's possible. Of course, if you look at insurance, new technologies also give superpowers to insurance carriers. Think of AI. Think of AI revealing patterns in data that we as humans cannot do. Or think of new platforms that actually enable new kinds of tailor-made products, almost with instant time to market. Think of mobile solutions that actually give access and protection to previously underserved customers around the globe. And even better, think also about technologies that actually give superpowers to both consumers and insurers. That's of course the ideal. So for example, IoT-driven technologies, connected home, connected connected cars, connected health, and the likes. Things that really decrease risk, and on the one hand, and on the other hand, they actually enable prevention. They enable all kinds of new services, actually. They enable us as insurance carriers to be closer to our customers and actually even improve their lives or even save lives, while at the same time actually increasing our efficiency and improving customer engagement. Obviously, that's the ideal. We strongly believe that these kind of superpowers should be unleashed in the ecosystems and platforms relevant to insurance. So having said that, welcome all to DIA Munich. This is actually our fifth edition. And this edition is all about creating those superpowers and platforms and ecosystems. That's also how we have actually created our program for these 2 days. The reason why Roger Peverelli and I actually started and founded DIA 3 years ago was to accelerate customer-centric innovation in the industry, especially by connecting the change agents at insurance companies with insurtech leaders. So how we have compiled the program now is really finding 50 insurtechs out of our database of several thousand that relate to that. And these insurtechs, they come from 28 countries, so from the Americas until Australia, from Asia until Africa, and obviously also a good deal of companies from Europe. Many of these companies, they actually unleash those superpowers, both for customers, well, and or carriers, in platforms and in ecosystems. Think of insurtechs that actually give access to a customer platform or an e-commerce platform, platforms that insurance carriers can tap into. Or think of insurtechs that actually close gaps in ecosystems. For example, API-driven solutions, blockchain-driven solutions, solutions that are actually all about connecting the stakeholders in ecosystems. We see loads of those kind of insurance or insurtechs, especially, of course, if you look at the previous conditions in the mobility ecosystem. For example, linking the connected car with body shops, with roadside assistance, with insurance, etc. But what you will see these days that this also is now strongly emerging, for example, in health. Also think about insurtechs, if you look at these for the coming 2 days, insurtechs that actually cross boundaries. For example, not only by connecting mobility with insurance, but also by connecting banking and fintech with insurance. We'll see several examples of that in the coming days. Now, in our latest book, Reinventing Customer Engagement, we mentioned that currently the discussion is mostly about challengers versus incumbents. We also mentioned that we think that this should shift towards a discussion about orchestrators versus nodes. And actually, that's all about the role that each company actually plays in the ecosystem. If you look at the InsurTechs speaking these 2 days, you will see that this now is starting to take shape, actually. And many of these, they actually create platforms as well to connect the players not only within the ecosystem, but also across ecosystems. And effectively, these InsurTechs are becoming orchestrators themselves, even if they are just startups. So what we do in these 2 days, we strongly encourage you to look at all these companies, especially from the perspective of superpowers in ecosystems and platforms. Well, as at all our previous DI events, we also ask you to judge each InsurTech on strategic impact. So if we say strategic impact, we mean how do they really deal with the challenges in the industry? How do they, for example, increase efficiency? How do they improve in customer engagement? And or how do they open up new revenue streams and the likes? At the end of each day, we'll ask you to choose your or select your 3 favorites. And tomorrow at 4:30, the 6 winners will receive the prestigious Diamond Award. Now, if you look at superheroes, they all have got their specific superpowers, of course. If you look at them, well, mostly it's about enhanced senses. It's about the ability to fly. It's about incredible strength, for example. And all of them get these strengths from all kinds of different backgrounds. If you look at Wonder Woman, her origins is as a Greek goddess and a lot of training, this is how she got her superpowers. Superman, of course, gets his from Krypton. And if you look at Batman, he actually, well, he's more or less a very scientific whiz kid that manages to create abilities on his own. Well, we are actually very happy that these coming 2 days we have a great lineup of thought leaders from across the globe, thought leaders with different kinds of backgrounds, and these thought leaders will give context, guidance, and inspiration during these 2 days. Context especially for those 50 InsurTechs on stage. First of all, we have got Simon Kessler and Jörg Mushoff of our knowledge partner McKinsey. They will be on stage, especially sharing their vision about the growing importance of ecosystems. Next, Ping En is without any doubt a worldwide best practice when it comes to successful ecosystem strategy. We have Jonathan Larson, CIO of Ping En, and he will share his vision on how Ping En is doing that. Whenever we speak in boardroom sessions, actually the most frequently asked question is, without any doubt, always, okay, when will we be Uberized? Well, actually there's a different approach to that. We have Vikas Charia of AXA and Curtis Scott of Uber, and they will share actually how they joined forces. And they will do that later today. Then tomorrow in our panel discussion, we've got Josep Salaya of Mapfre. We've got André Smit of Aviva, and we've got Joost Heidemann of Unive, and they will especially share their vision, their learnings, and their success factors in how to develop and especially also nurture ecosystems. Then to close off tomorrow, we'll have Nassim Settin of Allianz X and Gustav Agertsen, CEO of Bima. And both of them will actually build and foster ecosystems from different perspectives. Allianz X even looks into banking. Bima is also known for their, well, teaming up with telcos. And what they will do tomorrow is especially show how they look beyond the borders of the traditional insurance industry. Having said that, I would like to introduce my co-founder, Roger Peverell.